Hello everyone. Well, I'm here filming my Dancercise with Yasmin class, as lots of you suggested that I should. Please excuse the notes, but I've got quite a lot to tell you. I'm missing the classes so much, so I thought this would be the best way for me to do something with you that we can do at home together. Because I'm not physically with you, I'll be doing a lot more talking to try to make you get the best out of the class. But once you get to know the moves, you can fast forward me, you can rewind, you can pause, you're in control. So this is quite good. You can do this all at your leisure. This is why I thought about doing this instead of a live class, because we don't know what we'll be doing every day, and so this means you can put me on whenever you feel like it. This is a typical example of the morning classes I do, which are low impact and therefore suitable for everybody, but especially active seniors who've been told to stay at home. There's a few rules before we start though. Please make sure you're fit and well before you get started, and you've checked with the doctor if you've got any medical conditions that you're okay to do some exercise. Also, make sure someone's with you. Grab somebody to do this with you if you've got someone in the house, or if not, at least check in with somebody on the phone afterwards and let them know that you're okay. So let somebody know that you're exercising at home. Tell them how good it was to dance around your house. They might join in with you next time. Make sure you have enough space. So we're going to be moving about a wee bit. Arms, you're not going to bang into anything. You can go two paces either side of yourself. You can do two good paces forward and have nothing behind you. Please don't trip over anything or bang into anything. Also, a laminate or a wooden floor would be good. Not tiles, they're too hard for joints. But if you're on the carpet, you only got carpet, that's fine. But just wear a shoe that has a smooth sole, or sports socks, something like that, because we will be doing some moving and I don't want you to stick in the carpet and jar the knees and have any injuries. I think that's nearly it. Get yourself some water and a chair. I've got this one. So a kitchen or a dining chair would be good. Something where your feet will be on the floor, flat on the floor, and your hips are no lower than your knees. So don't be sitting in a chair like this. That will really go into your hip joints. So make sure you can sit up, and that, again, that you've not got maybe arms as well. So if you've only got arms, that's fine, but make sure that maybe they're not too high. You shouldn't be sitting in the couch. Okay, I think that's it. So let's dance. Okay, so here we go. First of all, think about how you're feeling. Make sure you've got nice, even breaths. Your shoulders are down, your tummy's pulled in, you're zipped up, okay? When we do everything, it will be tattooed on my forehead soon, I think. Knees over toes. When we're bending, if we're lunging, make sure your knees are over your toes. Don't be turning the foot out and pushing your knee in. I'll explain what we're doing as we go along and before we get the class. So a bit of fun for this one. The only bit I need to show you, I think, is the chorus part. We step forward, forward, back, back. Heels go out, in, lift, and out, in, lift. You'll see when the music starts. We do a jump. You don't have to do a jump if you don't want to, but jumping is good for the bones. So jump, we do a big stretch to the side, and open up, bringing it all from here rather than your shoulders. Don't lift your shoulders when we do that. Okay.
You wind up under it, you hide behind the mask, you.
beautiful Campsies in the sunshine. I can't turn you around or else it'll be too bright. So, okay. Now, we're all warmed up. Everything's feeling a bit looser. Now stand with your feet just apart so they're straight down from your hips, not too wide and not right together. And you're going to go down, chin to chest. And it's like, think of your spine as a bicycle chain, like a bicycle chain. So you're going down and really opening up the spine, okay? Use your hands as a gauge. So even if you're just going to here, that's fine. Or if you can, chin right down and go as far as you can and then roll back up again, chin to chest always. For a bit of strength and balance, up onto your toes, a nice big stretch, try and hold it, and then back down. Here you go. We're going to do some squats. Remember what I said about knees over toes. When you bend, make sure you have your knees over your toes, and then you're using the muscles. And then we're going to do a stretch over. Make sure it comes from here, like I said, rather than here. Okay. Told you I'd be talking a lot. Ready?
She would never say where she came from.
Remember,
yesterday, no matter if it's gone.
And again, down.
While the sun is bright, or in the darkest night, no one knows. She comes and goes.
Open the feet and the squat.
Why she needs to be so free. She'll tell you it's the only way to be.
Down again.
She just can't be chained to a life where nothing's gained and nothing's lost. Such a cause.
You're gonna squat again, just turn it in.
Breathe.
Goodbye. Room is you. Feel that in your body. Well done, well done, well done. Remember your breath. You should be really feeling that now in your muscles here, in your bottom. Everything's been wakening up. Your calves, your arms, round here, this core part, nice and strong. Okay, we're going to be doing some more stretching, but think about your breath. I was shouting, breathe in, breathe out. So when you're going for a nice stretch, try and use your out breath. So breathe in and then. And you go much further. The stretch is relaxed rather than and you're all tensed up. Okay? Okay, next. Oh, don't go yet. So some nice stretching. We're going to start with our shoulders. Keep your hips nice and straight. It's just this top part. You're giving all of this a nice massage. You're doing this, then we do our heads to the side again, really stretch. Then we're going to lift up, up. We do that four times. We go up onto our toes, down, out, and up, down, out. Okay? The chorus, one, two, three, four. Or I don't know if it's a chorus, part of the main thing. Then we're going to do a kind of body roll. So you go down, come up onto your toes, push your pelvis forward and roll back. And this is to strengthen all of this up and open up your pelvis so you're having a bit of a move. Let's try. You'll like this one. Some of you haven't done this yet.
What it was.
Head.
Salt pills on the table for your unrequited love.
Shoulders.
You
can bend your knees a wee bit.
Out you holding me up. Now strong enough for all of us.
Straighten that back up. And you can jump up. It's wonderful. I won't shout all your names out, but I can see all your faces. Okay. Beautiful day. Beautiful day out there. Oh, what I was thinking is if we have these beautiful days, I might try to look at where we can do an outdoor class. Surely they will let us do that if we stay apart enough. So I'll keep in touch about that. Anyway, plies next. Good old plies. So your heels are going to be together. Plies are great because they use so many muscles in your body, your legs, but also trying to strengthen these muscles around the knees, around the hips, your bottom, keeping your core strong. So many things, so many different things. Key things not to do. Bottom doesn't stick out when you bend. Then nothing's happening here at all. And knees, do not come forward like this. You will do yourself an injury. Please don't do that. So even if it's a small bend, think about opening these muscles out, knees over toes, and then pulling up with all of the muscles around here. So going down and then up. Don't go down and up. Not much will happen then. Use your muscles to go down. Use them to come back up again. Okay? This is nice and slow. We're doing some pointing as well. So this is all for balance, to get ourselves nice and strong. So you're going to point forward. Now when you point, really point your toe, stretch your foot out, and then all your muscle is engaged. If we just kind of do that and sink into it, nothing much is happening. But we're here to exercise. So point forward, in, then we go to the side, in, then the back, waking up your bottoms, in and side and in. And we do that on the other side as well. We're also going to lift a bit. Lift and lift and side. And that's to just open up all of these muscles as well and help with balance. Build up to that, or if you've got that chair handy and it's got a pretty high back, hold on to the chair. You could put the chair in front of you for this. So you can use it for doing your plies, and you can use it for doing your pointing and stuff as well, okay? So build up to that, but I know you can do it, so let's see. Okay, oh, I knew I'd be talking too much. Here we go. Bottoms in, shoulders down, and breathe.
Friday night, I'm going nowhere, all the lights are changing. Breathe.
And you're going to lift onto your toes. Again,
turn
down.
Turn on the TV station, situations running through my head.
Lovely. And open your feet.
In time, you know it's clear.
Watch the shoulders. Don't stick your bottom out.
To open up my heart to all the jealousy, that bitterness that we need.
Then we're going to point forward.
And if you want it,
side,
come and get it.
Keep zipped up.
Crying out loud.
Other leg.
The love that I want.
Watch your shoulders.
And you were never in doubt.
Lift.
Through the crowds and the chemicals rushing in my bloodstream.
everybody in the class. You should be feeling things happening now. Muscles are, woo, feel the burn, as they say. So that's your muscle cells going, woo, I need to do something. Your bone cells are having to do that as well. We're bouncing around. So it's really your body, remember, tricking its way into regenerating. And as I always say, not rejuvenating. We'll get there somehow one day. Okay, this is our warrior one. We normally do this facing each other so that you get out of your box. It's all very well you just watching me, but so that this is also a brain exercise, which dancing is, it's really good for the brain. I want you to start moving around and not always just looking at me. So as you know from the classes, I get you facing each other, going through each other, kind of working with partners or in columns, rows, crossing over. We do lots of different things. Bit more difficult when we're in our houses. So I've adapted this a wee bit, so we'll just watch me, follow me. But work up to doing it with somebody facing you, if you can. So grab someone that's in the house, if they're there with you, and get them to do it. Remember, you're on the same leg, the same arm, but when you face each other, you think you should be mirroring each other. And I don't want you to do that. That's where the brain comes into it. So this is our stamp, stamp, stamp. But I'm going to do it on the other side so that I'm mirroring you. So, right, left, right, stamp, left, right, left, stamp. So that toe goes on, or you can stamp with your ball of your foot, and a nice strong arm. You'll like this music. Poor river dance, everything's getting cancelled, but this is like our river dance song. We then go to the side, two, three, stop, side, two, three, stop. We do that a few times. We do a big stretch up. Watch the shoulders, don't come up. Clench the fists. Punch out right, left, in, right, left, in. Then we do pas de bas. Do this at your own pace. You can just step if you want to. Or bounce as high as you can. So pas de bas, one, two, three, one, two, three. And that's about it. We just keep doing that and repeating. We do a walk in a circle, and I still want you to do that. If you're with a partner, if you're with somebody, try and walk around each other. Nice, slow steps with a straight back, and then you walk round the other way. Okay, let's do it. Ah, we should be outside today. Okay, so right foot first. Ready?
we got it together, didn't we?
Not yet. I hope you're feeling uplifted with that. When we do that in the class, it's just so strong. It's sending a message out of just, yes, we can do it. So, this is when we finish off the class with a wee bit of disco. With this one, think about where you were, what you were doing, what you were wearing when this comes on. It's a wee bit of fun. So, if you ever watched Ally McBeal, this is a wee take on something that they did with this song, and they did a bit of dancing. So the main kind of move is 1, 2, 3 to the side, 1, 2, 3, and you can come forward if you've got the space. Then I want you to step back and reach forward as if you're reaching for something you can't quite get. Four back. And then we do a stretch to the side, a stretch to the other side, and round in a circle. Watch the shoulders. Let's go, let's do it.
We got it together, didn't we?
I bet you didn't think, did we?
We've definitely got it together.
At whatever time in the morning, maybe you're doing this? So think about where you were.
I can even feel myself slipping in more and more ways. Less of a world of my own. Nobody but you. My land, my everything.
Okay. Fun time. Not over, but let's have a bit of a rest. Have a drink and just settle back into what you're going to do with the rest of the day. So, after all that fun, we're going to do some stretches, get our hearts and our minds, our blood pressure, our breathing, all back to normal again. We don't want to sit down straight away. We want to just stretch out and make sure that we feel we've still got that lovely stretch and that posture. Our shoulders are down and we go on for the whole day like that. I hope. Okay, remember what I said about sitting down. Don't sit down yet. When we do come to sit down though, remember, keep the knees apart, keep the feet apart. We all get into this habit of maybe doing this, getting up like this, crossing our legs and getting up like that, holding on to something else. Really try as much as you can to use the muscles in your legs. Keep the knees apart, make sure the chair is there, and sit using the muscles, not using your hands if possible. And then when you get up, take a breath in and breathe out and use those muscles again. If you can actually just do that a few times a day, it's really good for fitness, your balance and your strength as well. But don't sit down yet. We're going to do a few stretches first of all. You're going to be holding onto the back of your chair, but don't hold on to it. I don't want you to be really hanging on for dear life. You're just using it for a wee bit of balance, okay? So we're going to be stretching our hips. You're going to put your foot just behind your front foot. Keep your body nice and straight. And then stretch over and give yourself a nice stretch down the side of your hips. It shouldn't be sore, it should be a nice stretch. Then we'll do our calves. Stretching back, nice straight back, heel down. We'll do our quads as well. If you can, bring the foot up to the bottom, knees in line with each other, and give your quad a nice stretch. But if you can't get the foot up, foot back, heel down, and give your calf and the back of your knee a nice stretch. That's really important to do that. If the back of your knee gets all tight, it can really cause lots of problems at the front. So you're either here or you're here. And then you'll drop that foot and come into a nice hamstring stretch. Lift the toe. We'll do that on both sides. Then we come around and we do everything else sitting down. So remember when you sit down to keep the knees apart and use the strength. And you can copy everything that I'm doing. The only bit I'll show you, at the end, come forward in your chair. You want to have your feet open but still pointing forward. We reach up, we don't bring our shoulders, don't be doing this, keep them down. You take a nice breath in and then as you breathe out, reach for something as if you're passing someone a beach ball. And then when you get to the point you cannot reach anymore, then roll yourself back up again, building yourself chin to chest so that your spine is getting a nice stretch and then a roll, okay? And then we'll stand up from there, making sure that we feel okay first. Right, let's get started. I'm going to be facing you, so remember what we were doing with, I'll shout through so that I can, I'm saying so that I can see you, but I can see you in my mind. Okay, let's go. So you'll be behind your chair. Nice straight back. Over and slowly swap over. going to bring your foot up into this quad or stretch of the calf. Too far forward. Bring your knees apart. tonight. Lovely, wonderful. Relax your shoulders. Open the feet a little bit. And don't bend your knees, but just soften the knees, soften the hips. Feel your body relax a bit, but feel that posture, your posture, feel that strength. Shoulders are down. No little niggles in the head and the neck. Keep relaxed. And thank you for doing the class. Well done if you did it all. Well done if you did bits of it. You can now do what you want with the class. A wee bit here and a wee bit there. But tell me how you got on. And if this works, doing it this way, and we're stuck for a while, then I will record other classes as the time goes on. And we'll see how we get on doing this together, but at home. So thank you for joining me, looking in. I could see all of your faces. It was so good to imagine we were all there in the class. So I hope you did that too. And I'll speak to you all soon. Well done.